Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa, Kirigiri Havoc. With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We found that Chihiro was actually a male, which was interesting because it turned the entire case on its head. And now I'm going to continue on and try and ascertain who the actual murderer is, hopefully by this episode. So I'm running without any time today, but I've got Audacity open up, so hopefully we'll get a nice accurate end of the episode. So let's just continue on. Very interesting. It's become very interesting indeed.
He's off in his own little world.
What about you, Makoto? After everything we've learned, do you still think Byakuya's
He didn't. It seems to me like he didn't know.
Without a doubt, Byakuya is the one that made Chihiro's death look like genocide. Jack did it.
Yes.
But I think he might not actually be the killer after all.
He made it look like genocide Jack, probably just to get genocide. Just to get Toko off his case.
But aren't you the one who accused him in the first place?
Yes, we're on the hunt for truth.
Easy going about all this. Like he's enjoying us solving the mystery. The way he's acting, it makes it seem like it doesn't have anything to do with him.
Exactly.
And you think that might
it seems
he
didn't know that, it didn't know that Chihiro was a boy, first and foremost. And he also didn't seem to know about the crime scene being switched.
Plus, the evidence he left behind was a little too, how can I put it, overt. He consciously chose to use the extension cord, knowing it could connect.
Yeah, Tagami doesn't. He's intelligent. He wouldn't make that kind of mistake.
That's how I see it.
And Byakuya, he made purposeful, stupid mistakes.
When you found out the murder took place in the boys' locker room, it seemed to rattle you. And then again, when you found out Chihiro was actually a guy. If you really were the killer, that stuff wouldn't have had any effect on you.
Yes.
So that's your thinking, huh? Well, it bothers me that you don't have more concrete reasons, but it's fine. I guess I'll mark it as correct for the time being.
Mark it as correct?
What is this, some sort of like driver's ed teacher? That's a minor.
Right. I am not the culprit. I just happened to come across the corpse in the girl's locker room.
That is grim, that though. That is harsh shit.
Are you fucking with us right now?
No, I am not effing with you right now. I'm telling
I
you.
I do not swear. You fucking asshole.
Well, I find it very hard to believe.
Go ahead. Find it very hard to believe. You're free to be executed along with the rest of us.
If you're really telling the truth, then why? Why do you do that to his body?
If he says, he's gonna say for fun.
My reasons hardly matter right now. Uncovering the culprit is much more important, wouldn't you say? Now then, if it wasn't me, who was it?
Well, I don't think I can say for sure without talking about it a little more.
We're seriously gonna keep going? We're all good, aren't we? I thought it was clear Byakuya did it.
No, I'm with Makoto. If there's any doubt whatsoever, we need to explore every possibility.
But okay, so let's look at what we know. Wait a minute, I'm getting wrapped up about these e-handbooks that I read. In the lobby, there was the two girls' handbooks, which we're assuming would have been used in this case to get into the girls' locker room. And was also one broken e-handbook. Now, this e-broken handbook is supposed to be Leon's, okay, but Monokuma is insistent that the execution that Leon had could not have broken the e-handbook, and I'm tending to believe Monokuma because Monokuma has got no reason at all to lie. He's in this for fun, and if people get killed, then he's happy. So what I'm thinking is someone found a way to break the e-handbook with the one Achilles heel, which we know exists, but we don't know what it is, and then switched it with Leon's actual handbook. So someone in this room has got Leon's handbook instead of their own. That's what I'm thinking at the moment. Okay, so let's just continue on and see where the game leads us.
That's true. Very well then, I'm with you too.
Damn straight, count me in.
Get me in, dude.
Do you not have a mind of your own?
No.
Of course I do. What am I, an ant or something?
Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Until Monokuma gets annoyed.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
Shut up, Tagami! If Byakuya didn't do it, then who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? There's one thing I'm sure that we know about the killer. The killer was able to gain access to a real murder scene, which means... the killer is a guy.
I got it!
Has to be. Okay. Since the crime scene was the boys' locker room, you would need a boys' handbook to get in. Since the anyone's handbook is apparently broken, the killer would have had to use their own. In other words, it had to have been a guy. If that's still not enough, I need to find some more clues. Okay. I'm still of the mindset that is not actually Leon's handbook. It's someone else's. Celeste's account. What was Celeste's account again?
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues are one thing, but... did nobody get a look at the killer?
No, we couldn't have done it.
Sure, if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Monokuma, but
perhaps
we all know what
Monokuma is. At some point. Even that might be enough for now.
Celeste, that's what's...
All we need right now is any kind of new info.
Oh, shit. Okay. Come on, let's come out. Does he say shit or shoot? Shoot.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Okay, let's just go for the entire thing.
Clues are one thing, but... did nobody get a look at the killer?
I know Celeste got a look at Chihiro when she went in. Oh, he should have seen. When Chihiro went to go to the gym.
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
It's over. It's all over.
Game over, man. Game over.
Saw the victim? The killer. And only the killer.
There you go. Celeste did.
No, it's wrong.
Look at me when I'm shouting at you, bitch.
I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
Now that you mention it, yes. I did see him.
Yes. Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this.
Makoto? God, I love Celeste's accent. It's just so nice. The voice acting on that's really good.
Idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises.
Whatever! Just hurry up and tell us!
Shut up, bitch!
Right before nighttime, I saw Chihiro in the dormitory warehouse.
Okay.
I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag. And then, okay, I assume he headed off to exercise.
How did she get hair like that? That's insane!
Duffel bag?
Freaking cosplays, man. They can do anything.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
In a hurry for what?
He told me he was in a hurry. But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone was waiting for him, I should think.
So, Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always declined.
Because he was a boy, and he
was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Yeah. Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much.
Okay,
enough, so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
But... who would you have trusted?
Oh, the marvelous friendship!
No, you can't kill them.
Is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
No. You already have what you need to make the connection.
Huh?
What?
You know who the killer is.
Seriously?
What?
Who is it? Who's the killer?
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
Are you sure about that?
What?
You really think we can figure out who did it based on
what?
Two pieces of evidence that we don't have?
Come on, Brain, put it together, put it together.
Track down some fingerprints or something?
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use it.
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
What am I?
Maybe, but we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Okay, brain. We're working on the fly here. We're gonna have to guess.
Celeste, did you notice anything special about the bag or jacket?
The bag was just a normal duffel bag from the warehouse.
Yeah.
All and it the was... bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make that one special.
I wouldn't be talking about the tracksuits.
Right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from. Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit and Chihiro's jacket?
Eh?
Perhaps. Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
How would it make a difference? Chihiro's jacket really holds some clue about the killer. Someone's really hard to believe. It is. Miss my jam! What's the count?
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed.
To the gym.
He was on his way to go exercise.
Yes.
So next week.
And had to meet someone.
Why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
Yeah.
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him?
Oh!
My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit. Because exercising sucks.
Oh, she trapped a water.
I got it from the warehouse. If you.
You. Oh.
Did any of that really
you cheeky bitch.
Closer to figuring out who the
because a water just said blue jacket.
Not a chance.
How did he know it was a blue tracksuit?
You heard him, right? What he just said without even realizing it?
You tricked him. You tricked Iwata into like. She's so intelligent.
All, I think I'm in love.
He was on his way to go exercise. So next.
What an underhanded tactic, but I love it.
Why did he choose this specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean the specific?
Tasha, I'm sorry. I found a new true love.
I got it.
Guys, if you don't hear me from a few days, my girlfriend killed me.
So what you're
my wife.
The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as
how do you know that?
It's wrong.
Get ready, you shit!
Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just say?
Huh? What'd I say?
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said...
I saw him stuff your track tracked into a duffel bag. And then I assume he had us to exercise.
She never said anything about the jacket's color. So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
Oh.
What are you? You just.
Hey, Celeste.
Just F you up.
What color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
As a matter of fact, it was blue.
Oh dear. Get wrecked.
Began the trial. Did you tell anyone that?
The only one I told about any of this was you.
Then, Mondo, how did you know what color Chihiro's tracksuit was?
Because I'm sure he saw the clothes at some point in the investigation.
Oh, yeah, they're best friends, so he's gonna defend.
No, that can't be it. The bag and clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was... is if he saw Cherry with it before he died! That's the only possibility!
Oh, shit, Mondo!
Are you talking about your hero? So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night. He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
No, that can't be it either.
She stuffed it in the foot bag and walked off, didn't she?
Testimony.
Oh, he did. I'm sorry. I'm struggling to say he.
Stuff a jacket into a bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And to say what, she was gone.
When Celeste noticed it, Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag.
Oh, Mondo, you
just
don't know.
Briefly, you couldn't possibly have seen what color the tracksuit was.
Yeah.
It would appear you've dug your own grave.
Oh,
perhaps.
Shit. Don't say it like that, Kirigiri, come on.
That's why you said what you did. Focus on the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of
Ah, now I understand. It was all one big bluff, wasn't it? Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit. That's why you said you knew who did it. To put
that is very intelligent. I thought I'll hand it to Kirigiri.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about him from the very beginning.
Yeah, I'm sure you did, Kirigiri.
What made you so suspicious?
That's a good question.
Because I hate him.
We talked.
There was a certain turning point that tipped me off. Maybe you didn't notice it, Mondo, but you tend to refer to men and women.
I did notice up in the build-up that he called Chihiro dude.
You only call guys.
Yeah.
For girls, it's chick. And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude.
Yeah.
Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
It did seem odd to me, but I just thought it was Mondo being Mondo.
She's a witch! You're positively frightful!
No, I'm not the frightful one. Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Sick burns!
Mondo, was it really you? Did you really kill Chihiro?
I didn't kill anyone!
Oh, here we go.
Over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth.
What come on, Mondo, don't be unfair.
Like a goddamn criminal. Yeah, he would never do something like that. This is a false accusation.
It's true.
Come on, guys.
On that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
This does present us with a problem. It seems we're all out of leads.
So now what do we do? Oh yeah, you might have said he knew something, didn't he?
That's what my little ghost friend is telling me. Oh yeah, that reminds me. Kifumi, weren't you telling me you found some evidence?
Watch, it's going to be completely pointless and useless.
What kind of evidence?
Actually, no. Now that I'm thinking about it here calmly, it might not be all that relevant.
I found some porn mags!
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
If you really insist, then... Here it is.
What do you have there?
It happens to be an e-handbook. I found it laying on the ground, so I scooped it up.
So there's two broken e-handbooks. Found it on the ground, right? They must belong to... It's Mondo's Chihiro's.
Mine! Give it right to me!
Is it Mondo's? Oh, it's the Mondo, isn't it? Yep.
But I have mine.
Who is it?
Shoot!
It's Chihiro's?
I got it!
Is it?
We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
Oh. Did Mondo know how to break these e-handbooks?
For a fact.
For a fact indeed. I was totally sure I'd found it.
But it must hold some clue about the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
So I've got two broken handbooks.
The culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
Unless someone knew how to break them.
They're not. They're totally waterproof and shock-resistant. It would take an awful lot to break one.
And yet, this one does appear to be broken, as is Leon's, sitting useless in the main hall. For all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there somewhere?
How did they get broken?
How precisely did the handbook
I'm too good at this stuff, me. Oh, I'm not break. By hitting its weak point. Which someone knew about. And we're assuming it's going to be Mondo at this point.
Yeah, you remember that? Sure, maybe I I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was.
But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in
quick
succession,
then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness. You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
It's not an intelligence.
You're asking me?
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
He doesn't want this to be a fair trial.
If I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
He's not going
to
tell us.
Already. Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example? Then allow me to make a special announcement. The weak point of my cutting-edge
is he actually really going to tell us?
When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break!
I'm thinking sauna. Because Mondo went into the sauna with all his clothes on, didn't he? And we assume his handbook would have been in there as well.
You knew it? Yeah, because I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
Oh shit, there you go.
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh?
That is interesting.
It's because as your sweat evaporates, it creates a cooling layer of air around your skin. If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely get fried.
Is that true?
That layer of air would get blown away. That's why you may feel a burning when you move around.
I've been in a sauna a couple of times, but I've never had that experience of burning. But then again, I was kind of young, so...
So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Health advice from Monokuma.
I learned one new fact today.
We're in the middle of a murder case, man.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
Anyway, if you found the victim's back to the murder. In the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
They found it by chance.
Indeed. Quite the mystery.
What if they found out by accident?
There you go.
What do you mean by accident?
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness, and it broke? They'd realize it was broken, of course.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't be hard to figure out
why. The only thing you've done different.
And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
I won't say it's not possible.
It's a bit lazy to put it in the sauna and leave it there, though, isn't it?
I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
I do.
I might know someone who did.
Whoa! Seriously?
Yes, I do.
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
Kishimaru knows. But we're going to select the person in the next episode, because I'm out of time for this one, so... Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.